Good morning, everybody. It is the 3rd of May, and we're over here in Pennsylvania.
For some reason, my camera stopped recording in the middle of my pre-hunt interview this morning, so I'm just going to fill you in on kind of the situation. So the night before, I went over to Walmart, and on my way, I did some turkey scouting, and I found two longbeards and a group of hens that were out in a cut cornfield, and it borders right next to where public land is. So I figured, you know, this morning I would get in there really early. I got into the parking spot right there at like 4:15 this morning, extremely early, and got down on this high ridge that borders this piece of private. And that's what you missed in the pre-hunt interview. I don't know what happened to it, but so that's the deal here. So you're not going into this hunt blind.
Let's go ahead and get our stuff and get down in the woods and see what we can do this morning.
Okay, I'm all set up on these birds. They weren't exactly where I thought they were going to be. They're quite a ways farther from the field. But they did gobble, so we're in the game. I have to see if I can pull them over this way. We're in good shape right now, though. Oh, I think I just spotted one of the hens up in the tree.
Well, the bad luck streak is over. There's my setup right there at the base of that tree. Man, those birds were really hung up there at like 45 yards. I had a couple jakes and a hen that was standing about 8 yards from me looking at that decoy, and I didn't want to move or call or anything to nervous I'd scare them. But Pennsylvania bird down. Now I've got all morning to hunt. We're gonna go to New York and see if we can get a New York bird. Beautiful public land Pennsylvania gobbler. I don't recommend using these on public land either. That's pretty dangerous. I was really aware of my surroundings. I was watching really close if anybody was coming up here, and with those turkeys all being right here, I was confident they would alert me if somebody came moving in. But with this, I keep it face down all morning until the turkeys are in front of me. That's when I'll lift it up and stick it in. So the whole time I'm sitting here, I'm gonna turn this off. The whole time I'm sitting here, it's just sitting beside me like that. You know, when you walk in and out, I take the fan right off and pack it in my back. So when you get to the tree, you set it up, lay it down. When the turkeys start gobbling and they're almost in view, that's when I just lift it up and stick it in the ground like that. This decoy's got quite a few birds killed. It's a nice big Pennsylvania tom. Let's go ahead and head to New York and see if we can get one in New York this morning. I got all morning. These Tideway turkey vests are sweet. I got that turkey packed right in my vest. I don't know if you can see it in the game pouch. And the seat on this thing is unbelievable with the backrest. It's just trouble. You have trouble trying not to fall asleep in it. They're awesome. Made it back to the truck. I wanted to show you guys how sweet this turkey vest is. It holds that bird in there nice and tight. Has really nice back padding. There's the beard, decently long, but not very thick. We're gonna go ahead and head to New York. Well, I figured while we're over here, I might as well stop at Tim Hortons and grab myself a coffee. And then we're gonna head to a green field that I seen birds out on at my buddy's place yesterday evening. So we're gonna hurry up. I'm gonna put this bird in cold storage in our basement. It's 38 degrees this morning, so it'll be fine before I'm done hunting. And then see if I can't do two birds, two states, one morning. I've always wanted to do it. This is a perfect opportunity to get it done. Why am I zooming in? And let's get after it. This is exciting.